something like that. It's embarrassing.
There's no such thing as too fast.
Tim West. Tim West. Writing a book. Writing a book card.
Going all in, baby. I was trying to bait it. Thought you played with my cock before? If I have, I don't remember.
Tim West.
Let's go. Ooh, woo.
Tim West.
If I can't lick the Colonel's fingers, I'm deleting my Twitch account. That's the plan. If at some point somebody's fingers, ideally the Colonel's, but somebody's fingers are not licked, the stream is over.
Forever.
Figured it out. The truth is, I don't like playing games. I only like winning. So I cheat as often as I can, in as many ways as I can, guarantee that I win.
Trying to fuck on me, man. He's trying to fuck on me real bad.
Seriously? You brought a boy? So fucking pleased with myself.
Alrighty. Hello, hello. We have returned once again with the Alan Wake, which I'm currently getting set up to see if I can get it to work the way that I want. Which it does not seem like it's going to. Question mark. No, okay. That's unfortunate, but it's alright. Not that big a thing for me to have to deal with. Just a little unfortunate. I don't want it to be that. I don't want it to be full screen. I just want it to be big. Beep, boop, beep. All right, so I'll just do this instead. Look at the purple. It's so pretty. All right. So we are back with the Alan Wake. We are on, I believe, the final episode, which means this will be the last stream of Alan Wake, assuming I'm not wrong. And if I am wrong, then this title is going to make me look a little silly. But as far as I can tell, that is not the case. From what I understand, this is going to be it. It'll be on the longer side of the chapters, of the episodes, so we'll see how long we actually go for. If it ends up not being very long, we might swap over and do something else afterwards, but assuming it takes an appropriate amount of time, we're going to finish the game today, and then, you know, maybe chat about it at the end or something like that. But for now, figure we can just continue.
In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking.
Oh yeah, that's right. So at the end of the last one, end of the last stream, a bunch of crazy shit happened, and then we woke up in our apartment, I guess, is what it seems like, I say as I run into the wall.
I wasn't sure if I could face the world without my sunglasses and something for my headache.
Something for his headache. He needs the sunglasses and something for his headache. Painkillers picked up. Good job, Alan.
The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again.
I don't think they work the instant they touch your tongue, though. That seems a little suspicious.
The lights were like needles in my eyes. I needed my sunglasses.
Okay, can't get in that door, I guess.
The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun.
Look at this fucking dude. Shek and Alan wait for this. Hey, what's up, Carson? How you doing?
There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
Wouldn't let me throw out sunglasses. That's neat. But yeah, I don't really remember what's going on at this point. Pretty much the most that I've got is that he woke up in his apartment and he's drunk as fuck. It's Friday, thank goodness. Amen to that.
New message. Ow! Are you still asleep? Wakey, wakey! You should have your show on your TiVo. If Alice wasn't too mad to record it, as she called me earlier and really chewed me out. Yeah, we went a little overboard last night. But parties are a part of this business. Al, look, I'm saying this as your friend.
What's up, Zen? Welcome in, welcome in.
Favors by trying to run your life like that, okay? I'll talk to you later, Al. Watch the show.
Watch the show. Okay, Barry, whatever you say. How are you doing today, Zen? And you too, Cursive. I know, thank goodness it's Friday, but loving Alan Wake 2, it's amazing. I'm happy to hear that. Night.
Talking about my latest book.
I'm very
the
happy
show was
for
supposed
you.
To be waiting for me.
I don't expect to ever want to play it myself, but I'm happy you're enjoying it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Harry Garrett Show.
Doing well, chilling. How am I doing? I'm doing good. We had a pretty relaxing day today. Looking forward to the stream, of course.
Alan Wake about his new book, The Sudden Stop.
Yeah, good read. Go buy it. No, it is a good read. Look, I'm going to be honest here.
Is that wise?
No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. But this one, I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan.
Wow, thanks.
Now, this might be a spoiler for those who haven't read the book yet, based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about this. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and 6 books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard. Always thinking of yourself. Well, you've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. And now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life with the ladies. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse. Okay,
I don't hate this game. I actually think this game is pretty fun.
So,
it's just, it's so fucking corny.
Good. Great.
This is so...
But I gotta say, I'm glad this is ridiculous. Back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Dude, I would too.
Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there who haven't bought it yet. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening. Alan Wake, Sam Lake. Once more, do the face for us, Sam. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you. And
at least I'd been funny. I told myself I'd live with that.
Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy.
That's so fucking loud. Shut up, TV.
You know what?
I should have followed her advice, but suddenly I was angry.
But, what is... Okay. This game is just skipping all over
what?
The place, I guess.
Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence.
Oh, shit.
Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal. Then you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight.
Yeah, her face is not 100%.
Just take a shower and
go back to bed. It's not perfect.
Yeah, you're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Peace and quiet. That's what we like. That's what we like to hear. It's peace and quiet. Yeah. We're going to go up to Maine. We're gonna rent a cute little cabin.
Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin.
Oh, that's what it was. That's right.
I had to return to
Colton
Lake to save Alice.
The biggest insult you can give a woman. Oh boy.
I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
Probably don't say that to any real people.
To read it first.
For everybody out there,
everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry, take her gun.
Alan, you threatened to shoot
Miss Weaver,
out there,
close the door when I leave.
Good luck, Al.
Thanks, Barry. Appreciate you.
See you later.
See you later.
When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake.
True.
On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Calder Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed.
Okay. Here we go. Wouldn't believe which character in this game makes it to the second one. Alan Wake. Was it Alan Wake?
Alone. In
I have
daylight,
a sneaking suspicion that it might have been
by
Alan
the beauty
Wake.
Of the Pacific Northwest landscape. It was hard
no,
not
I
to
feel
let
like...
doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk
let's,
everything
let's
up to a dream,
first.
A delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. there would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
No, I have a sneaking suspicion it was Barry, and if it was Barry, I'm upset. But look, what was this giant fucking ad for Verizon in my Alan Wake? Are you kidding me? There isn't even anything on it. It's literally just their logo. All right, whatever. But yes, no, back to what you were saying earlier. I actually do enjoy this game very much. It's just the gameplay sucks. And then every once in a while, there's something like that that's just the corniest shit I've ever heard in my life. And it looked like they did the dub and then, like, acted over it. So, like, the people in the scene that were, like, on the show weren't actually talking. So it was really weird and disconnected. Supposed to be following the road still? What are we doing here? Gameplay in the second game is much better. Okay, that's good at least. That's something. Oh. Okay, guess I can't get in there. Unless I'm supposed to, still. Let me through!
The darkness had touched me. There was a link between us, always would be.
Reported to the police, Alan.
I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
Johns. Nope. And it's nighttime.
I will kill your wife.
Ouch. Ow. You motherfucker. Reload the gun, Alan. Oh, did a 360 without meaning to? But that's legitimately very good to hear. I was, like, I wouldn't think that they would make it as piss poor as this one, given that it came out this year. But you never know. It really is, like, impossible to assume anything when it comes to games at this point. Oh, look at this, a car with the keys in the ignition. How convenient. But that is legitimately good to hear. In that case, I might pick that up at some point. Because I've heard overwhelmingly positive reviews, generally speaking, and if the game is physically better to play, then that sounds like it'll be significantly more up my alley than this one. Gotta pick it up later, too many games for now. That's true. There are still, there are definitely a lot of games that I'm in the middle of playing, so I'm not gonna be, like, picking up anything major. But I do definitely, I suppose this is okay. But I enjoy this one enough, and now it's, you know, a thing, so I can stream Alan Wake 2 at some point in the future, maybe like next year, if I ever get a goddamn job. Can I steal this truck? Is this what I'm hearing? That I can steal this truck? Because that'd be baller. This is just a set piece, I'm gonna be mad. I'm pissed. But yeah, no, there are a ton of games that I'm playing on my own. And a ton that I already, you know, own that I need to finish. And Alan Wake is not the kind of game I'd ever play by myself. So if I was to get Alan Wake 2, I would definitely want to just stream it. And I'd rather have a nice theme for that. So that would be like, you know, a Halloween in the future or an October in the future or something like that. But hearing it's good is good. That makes me a happy camper. It means I actually might be willing to. Right, what are we doing? Okay, great. Okay, love it. Alan Wake 2 is very demanding on PC specs, though, if you want to use all the graphics options, so keep that in mind. Yes, no, I was aware of that.
All the way out here. Wait. There was a link between us.
I hate
always
this.
Would be. I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
And I've definitely got a beefy PC. Like, my computer can handle it. see it. Yeet. Okay, Alan, now you reload the gun. Good job, Alan. You could do it. But yeah, so it maybe I'd have to test it out and see if my computer would be okay with streaming it at the same time. But again, that won't come for a decent while anyway, so it doesn't really matter too much. Back in the car I go. Hopefully I find a checkpoint that I just missed the first time. Because yeah, my computer is pretty meaty, but I'm honestly more than anything concerned about my internet. Because it already shits the bed sometimes for no reason. I don't know if it would like my computer having to work harder. So, am I supposed to be going this way? Is this the idea? I'm not sure if I was supposed to be able to do that, but I don't really care. Oh, shit. Stop throwing shit in my car. Wackies. Wackadoos. What? I just appeared on top of the car. Ah, whatever. So is this one not? There it is. Okay. So I guess I should have just stayed in the car and glitched out that barrier. That's alright. Flare? Yum. What is that? I don't like the look of that. Yeah, dude, that's so fucking great. Good lord.
What the hell?
That's a good question, Alan. Ow. Shit. Hey, Alan, you fucking weirdo. Okay, well, there goes that one. That can thrown at me either. Oh, someone dead. Ah, ha, 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 and there we go. Bye bye, Alan. This is gonna be so much fun. I'm so ready to have so much fun with this little section. Flares are probably gonna unfortunately be the way to go, but we'll have that one time. Dude, if that thing landed on me and killed me, I was gonna be so pissed. I was gonna be so mad. And I wouldn't have put it past it. It's the brightest.
What the hell?
Gotta fight past the poster, guys. Okay, grab that. There we go. Ooh, Alan, please. Alright. Excitement is so obvious. Yeah, no, I'm incredibly excited to be playing this game. This game is my favorite, it's so well designed. Yeah, no, I don't mean to be a Debbie Downer, but like, at the same time, thanks, Flare. Doing literally nothing. Get me out. Hello. Bye-bye. Ooh! Ooh! Just need to put some light on the action. Yeah, it seemed like that's all I need to do, actually, for the entire game, all the time. I see, it's not Satan. It was a crane. Who's next? Ooh, hello. Let's get you. Real quick. Alright, there we go. Maybe it could be less lighthearted. Trust me, so far this is anything but lighthearted. Ow. And there goes my flare. There we go. Get me out of here. Checkpoint, checkpoint, checkpoint. Thank you. I'll stand here for a second. Give me the health back. Yum, yum. Yummy, yummy, yummy health. Let's ride. What's up, Fambinos? What? Literally, what did I just bounce off? It's a fun. Okay, well, I guess I'm going down this way then. Let's go! Ah! And I hit a tree! Come on, Alan's car. Through the field I go. Bro, relax. What is that, like a monster truck? I feel like this car is going to explode. I really hope it doesn't. Is that a checkpoint? Probably not. Okay. Whoa! Rampant! Car, Alan. Give me the checkpoint, Alan. There we go. Oh, my lordy. Okay. Also, I feel like the driving in this game could be a lot of fun if I was allowed to do more stupid shit with it, but... Ow? Excuse me? The fuck was that? Oh, there's goo. I see. Dude does a good little chunk of damage, too. Surprised it does that much. Just get rid of it all, just be safe. There we go, got the double. So that's here. Oh, okay, I guess modern camping equipment is lightweight. Good to know. Okay, hello. Thanks, game. I love it. Okay, actually, fuck you, though. No. So you guys get. Fucking ammo island. I love not being able to see a goddamn thing. Because it's so blurry and weird. It's so much fun. Where's that come from? Okay. Okay, great. Love that. Let's get you, this game's fun. Where, like, the dodging doesn't trigger slow-mo. Oh, that's good. I like the cinematic dodging when it happens, like, every... How many of you fuckers are there? Jesus. I hate this. Bro, why are there so fucking many of them? Stop. Piss off. Alan, reload your goddamn gun. Dude, this is the worst. Why are there so goddamn many of them? Alright, you know, fuck it. I'm out. I just don't want to deal with you anymore. Get away from me. Why are there like 500 of them? And why are they all showing up behind me? I hate it. It makes me mad. Yeah, let's pick up those flares, why don't we? Like, I feel like I'm supposed to just be running away from these guys and not bothering, but then they show up behind me. So I really don't know what to do. Because fighting them is obnoxious and frustrating. So Zen, you said the gameplay of 2 is better, as in, like, the combat, the movement, all of it? Or did they, like, change up kind of the physical gameplay formula to make it more, Yeah, okay. Because obviously, as you guys know and can tell, the minute-to-minute gameplay is some of the worst in the fucking world. Has all these design choices that are just so goddamn bad. Now, Sandra's leaving. I don't want to deal with these guys. Okay, love it. Stop, dude. No more waves of enemies and there's actual stealth. Oh my god, that sounds like a dream. Yeah, obviously I made very apparent, really the only problem I have with this game is that all of the combat feels terrible and is designed to be obnoxious instead of either challenging or engaging. So having there be actual stealth, having there not just be 500 enemies thrown at you at all times, and having it all function better sounds like what this game is supposed to be. It sounds like what people think this game is what I'll say. Again, I hate just complaining all the time, but Jesus Christ. Okay, you need to back the fuck up. And he's already out of fucking stamina. I hate you so much. Yeah, y'all better back it the fuck up. Jesus Christ. It's open world, you can revisit any area at any point. Oh, that's cool. That's a neat little, I wouldn't have expected that. How does that work then for the, did it make them all disappear? Wait, that actually be hype. Okay, nope, it definitely did not. No stamina? Oh. That's incredible. It's like they looked at this game and realized all the things that made it not good and decided to take them out. What an incredible decision. Verizon, get out of my horror game. Get out of my spooky game, not horror game. But yeah, that is legitimately fantastic. Like, I'm very happy to hear that. Am I supposed to be going up this way, or am I supposed to still be following the road? That's another thing I'll say, is like, I can't tell if where I'm actually supposed to be going. Am I supposed to be going right there, or am I supposed to be just going around? Look, it's Verizon on the horizon. It's Verizon permeating my soul. Okay, I'm assuming I'm not supposed to go in here. Like, it points directly here, but I don't know if I'm supposed to be going this way or not. If I'm supposed to be following the road. It's also possible I just skipped a little chunk of gameplay, which I would not be upset about.
I had to get the gate open.
Okay, good job, Alan. Speedrun strat, yeah, apparently. I'm not upset about skipping small chunks of this. Let's follow the arrows. The arrows won't lead me astray, right? Alright, what do we got? What do we got? Where are we looking? Where are we looking? What do we got? Where are we looking? Who else? Who else wants them? Yum, 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 yum. Alright, works for me. So I gotta get the gate open, which I'm assuming means starting the power. So why did it just bring me all the way around there? Because I don't think the thing over there was interactable. It's funneling me over this way, but... Do you want me to put a flare down? Like, what do you want from me? I'm assuming he's just telling me about the stuff there, but... Very important thing if you ever decide to stream Alan Wake 2. Alright, lay it on me. Let's see where I'm supposed to go inside, but... Disable nu- Oh, there's nu- There's nudity? Why? But that is good to know. Thank you, Zen. There's a very apparent peepee. Oh, no. In the first 5 minutes. Oh, double no. What the fuck, you homie? Ow. Okay, I'll take hunting rifle. I can live with that. Now reload the gun. Really dick you early in Elm Lake too, huh? Apparently, ma'am. It is kind of funny that they just drop a dick on you. Just like right at the beginning. Not a fresh one. Oh no. We hate old spoiled peepee. Obese 50-year-old guy. Oh nice. Love that. Hey, there we go. Oh, hello. See that? That was actually a pretty decent little spook right there. He didn't blindside me. He didn't pull any bullshit. He was just there when I turned around. That was good. At least it isn't like Outlast giant PP. I'm now officially lost. But it's time to get to Cauldron Lake. With all my new goodies. Use a bitch. Oh, am I ramping it?
Yeah.
That was hype. And we ramp it. Come on, Alan, you can do it. Okay, I'm probably not supposed to. Probably not supposed to drive in here. Didn't play Outlast? No, I did not. Oh my god, I'm so strong. Alright, give me all that shit. But yeah, no, I don't believe I've played Outlast.
Like, the name sounds familiar, but
I don't actually know it. Fuck. Twin brothers who chase you the whole game and they keep fighting over gets your liver and tongue. They're naked? Oh. Okay, that's nice. pussy. Alright, so I don't know what I just opened, but I'm assuming it's something I need. Yeah, I'd rather you didn't do that. Alright, 50 point turn, it's fine. Alright, there we go. Not the bulldozer again. Okay, I actually can't get out that way, it seems. God, bro. Learn how to drive. Okay, well, the car's complete. Ow. Fuck off, maybe? Ow, fuck off, maybe? Christ, I hate this. You know what the last detail make me want to play on my way too? The puns? Ooh, baby. I love me some puns. Oops. Okay, well, didn't mean to have the flare gun equipped. Didn't even realize I had it. So that was a nice waste of a flare. Secondary character we play as keeps making dumb puns all the time. Oh, hell yeah. That actually does sound like a good time. It would definitely make it more enjoyable to stream, that's for sure. Am I just waiting for this? Is this what we're doing? Let me in, please. Let me in. Although I will say it's smart of them to keep putting cars everywhere because they keep making it so that cars will either randomly get destroyed trying to get where you're going or, you know, they purposely designed it to not fit, so then you just get another car. It's a little silly to do it when you could just have one car to make the whole trip instead, but Tokyo Drift. But at least they're not being assholes about it. Tokyo Drift. Alright, let's see what's in here. Gotta check all the emergency kits. Yum 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 yum. Lithium batteries, yum yum yum.
When I told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room, I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
True. Except for why, though? One thing I find weird is a design decision. Oh boy. Lay it on me. What'd it be? What'd it be? The boxes have randomly generated loot in them depending on what you have and how much of it. Oh god, I hate that. Weighted loot. Weighted loot is the worst thing in fucking history. Like, I get that it's easier to just make an AI that decides and feeds it to you. But it's still really goddamn annoying when you're looking for something specific and the game just decides that you have enough or you, you know, don't use it enough to need it. If you have too many resources, you might find nothing in the boxes. Yeah, that's just silly. I think, if I remember correctly, Borderlands 3 does something similar where the ammo chests that you find will, like, calculate what you need and drop based on that, but instead of actually, sure, let's grab this, why not, but instead of actually, like, looking at your ammo count and deciding what you need to get to full, it just gives you a ton based on your, like, recently used weapons, which obviously isn't helpful, because if I use my rocket ammo and then need more rocket ammo, and never need more rocket ammo, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Easy way to cheat the game on it, hell yeah, love that. That's gonna be back in the fuck off. This incredibly loud bullshit. deposit your item in the safe to enter your inventory, the golden box or some tons of loot. Oh, sick. That's nice. Nope, not the shotgun, Alan. Not the shotgun. Look at this. Let's turn that on. Is anybody actually coming, or are we just sitting here for no reason? Okay. Oh my god, he actually made it in. I'm amazed and impressed. But I thought I already had a shotgun. I probably got the pump action done. Yeah. Stress to mark the box on the map without opening them, coming back later when the inventory is empty. That's kind of sick. That's a good little, like, developers make a stupid decision and get in the people playing the game immediately figure out ways to cheat it. That's good shit. Like, of course, that's super obnoxious that you have to do that in the first place, but at least people will figure out how to. Fine, you're getting the shotgun. Bitch. Ow. Alan, fire the goddamn shotgun. Big ass. Pussy ass. Big ass. No stamina. Have an ass. Bitch. But yeah, that does legitimately sound very annoying. Okay. I don't even know who's firing at me at this point. Come here, motherfucker. So you decided to kiss that pickaxe, that was an Alan mistake. Hi, hero. How you doing? I love this game so much. It's so fun and well made. But yes, how you doing, hero? How you doing today? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Hello, hello, howdy, howdy. Beep, boop, bop. I'll take the pump action, I guess. Because I have more ammo for it. We'll go, ooh, what's going on over here? Ooh, it's so spooky.
I will never give her to you.
Okay. Ah. Crazy bitch stole my work. A little bit, game, and I decided to hit the brakes. Love that. Again, didn't mean to use the shotgun, but whatever, I guess it's fine. Big guy, I'm just gonna give you a little bit of that, a little bit of focused light here. You'll bear with me a second. Reload. Let's do this quick reload. Reload the gun, Alan. Fill up all those holy. The revolver ammo. Thank you. And then PM on Friday, literally the most heavy traffic of the week. That's a fair point, actually. Yeah, okay, so obviously I can only speak to American ISP bullshit, but throttling internet speeds should not be a thing. Like, if I'm, you know, paying to get whatever it is that I'm getting, it should not be contingent upon nobody else using the internet at the same time. Obviously, that's not so easy to actually control, but it's still really annoying. will stand by that statement until the day I die. Here we go. Also, reload your goddamn gun, Alan, you freak. You don't want to deal with the big guys, if I'm being honest. Oh, got three of them. Hell yeah. Big cinematic explosion for me. I assume Zen is running local hubs and not arbitrary filing for the sake of capitalism, but rather literal hardware and the local infrastructure. That's fair. I would also, that's a fair point. I can't see anything because it's a flare. Alan, wait. Shoot your goddamn gun. Wants it. You want it, don't you, big guy? You want some shotgun? I love Alan Wake. Good lordy, lordy, lord in heaven. Correction for the Alan's sake of capitalism. There it is. If there's a word that you can make a pun out of, it is a requirement that you make a pun out of it. That's the rules. Alright, where's the guns? I know they were in one of these buildings. I don't remember which one. Probably this one. Yup. Pick up the revolver. Thanks, Alan. Took you long enough, you freak. Alright, if I pick up the normal shotgun, it gives me two bullets. But if I pick up the Alan Wake sliding on fucking ice rink, I'll take five. Okay, I'll take five. And off we go. Do you want to save those bolts though? I'm so tired. Shut up, Alan. Get on a treadmill, goddammit. Okay, now I'm gonna hide in the corner for a second while I plug something in. All right. Now back to business. So I love the texture on that box. Looks real pretty. I was nice and up close to it. I don't know if any of you saw the Chevalier trailer, new Tekken 8 character by Vincent Kessel. I did not. I don't really follow Tekken. So I don't know anything about anything that's happening pretty much ever. Made me hate knowing how to speak French. Oh no. Is the voice acting terrible? Ah, that's tough. Okay. Alan Quake. Exactly. Whee! Come on, pussy. Turn the light. It's like he's reading from a script. No soul, no nothing. Ah, that's tough. Raidnik's John Wick-ass character. Nice. Showed up, read the script, took his paycheck, and fucked off. I mean, I get it. But at the same time, like, that's
Mirror Peak in the distance.
Very unfortunate.
That's where Cauldron Lake was.
Okay. Thanks, Alan. But yeah, that does suck. Like, I can understand... Like Castle. Oh, I don't know who that is necessarily. Yeah, I mean, I might recognize the voice, but I don't necessarily just know them. Gimme. All right. Oh, do I get to go in the minecart? Do I get to ride in the minecart? I want to ride in the minecart. Jesus Christ, Alan, please. You absolute knob. Oh yeah, it's minecart time. don't think Tekken 8 devs would mind, though, considering the base the entire personalities of characters around their nationality. That is true. Yeah, Tekken is not it's not very much, it's the Alan break. There it is. But, you know, Tekken is definitely not, like, made with the character quality in mind, I guess. Like, the whole point of Tekken is that it's fucking ridiculous. Okay, good job, Alan. It's a good thing it waited until I got out before it fell over. True Fighter does the same kind of thing. Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. Like, fighting games, as much as I love them, really don't put a ton of effort into character. Some games obviously have lore, and they try to make it like a thing, but... Vincent Castle is a very well-known Hollywood actor. You surely know him. Oh, okay. Then after these birds glitch through that... Fuck them birds. Hold on. I'm gonna look them up real quick. His character design is diverse in Street Fighter 6, and unlike Tekken 8, female characters don't look like one another with a different dress and wig. Yeah, that is true. Vincent Castle. Oh, yes, I do recognize his face. I mean, although, you know, the same can be, at the same time, what you could say is, why are they hiring screen actors to do voice acting roles? Like, a voice acting and screen acting are significantly different. And you're only going to get... There's, like, a significantly higher chance of getting a bad performance out of a screen actor when you could just go hire a voice actor instead. Which seems incredibly silly to me, but, you know. Like, it makes me wonder why people keep hiring screen actors to do voices and things. And the answer is because, oh, look, it's a name that people recognize. Okay, bye-bye. Because French character, I mean, yeah. But that's what I'm saying, like, they could very... What was that? They could just as easily find a voice actor who speaks French, or is French, or whatever, and they would get a significantly better baseline performance. So, like, why not just do that? You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, Vince, I recognize his face, sort of, but, like... He's definitely not, he's not like a name, like a home, you know, a home name. Like, I wouldn't just see him and go, oh, hey, that's Vincent Castle. Like, there's no point. Like, Megan Fox, MK1, I mean, yeah. Ow, fuckers. You remember how I hate this game? Because I'm not allowed to fucking see anything. Jesus Christ. Dude, what? Is there shit on? Oh my god, there's ground goo. Are you serious? Why would you put ground goo when it's so fucking dark and blurry? I can't see anything. Jesus Lord in heaven. Because they want to hire Brittany to create attraction. No, absolutely, and that's what I'm saying. Like, I understand, it's, you know, why they hired Chris Pratt to be Mario instead of literally anybody else. But it's like, it just comes down to whether they care about quality or not. And in Tekken, I wouldn't think they would have a reason to necessarily. Whereas in, you know, a movie, it's more important. But I still think they should care about quality and just don't, but you know, that's just the nature of things. I heard the hot Alan take. I'll be honest, this game isn't very good. Yeah, like I you know, I've said it over and over again, I like this game, I'm enjoying playing, like, I'm enjoying the experience of this game, but physically playing it is just terrible at all times. It is unfortunate. Which is part of why I'm happy to is at least part of why I'm happy to hear that Alan Wake 2 is supposedly actually good. I'm just gonna toss this down real quick. Don't know where big homie went, but I guess that's fine. Oh, there he is. How many of you are there? Fucking Christ. Good lordy, Lord in heaven. Alright. Let's get this moving and grooving. Hey, yeah. Yum, 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 yum. Alright. Onward we go. Okay, what is happening now? Why is shit just randomly falling from the sky? And why are people randomly showing up behind me? It's very annoying. I don't like it when this happens. Gun, Alan. What was that one about? Where? These guys are very annoying. I guess I can't keep track of them if I wanted to. Because this game decides that anything past 2 inches in front of my face needs to be ridiculous and blurry. Fucking A. Okay. I'm happy to hear the FBI agent will play as an Alan Wake. It's literally Francis Stewart Morgan. She's no detective work. Let's go. What is hap- why? I'm actively getting attacked and it pulls the camera off me? That is egregious and stupid. Ay-yi-yi. And now here comes another one. Dude, I just can't with this. I both can't and don't want to with this. Okay, really, 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 really? Fucking A, man. You know what? Fuck it. I'm just staying here so you can only come out from here. Fuck it. Francis York Morgan's inspiration to true crime investigation. He is the only real detective to ever grace anyone's screen of any kind. Well, let me pick up. Okay, that's probably a flare, but now. Where's the other one? The other little shit not wanna come play anymore. Isn't that right, Zach? I love it. I also love doing giant threes. I didn't actually mean to throw that. Sick, I've got one bullet. Let's walk over to the haunting rifle. A haunting rifle. A haunting rifle? Hee hee! You know? Why? For why? Literally for why? Ay-yi-yi. Alan Wake. Alan Wake. Alan Wake. Europe being in that case the best decision DP Dev's ever made turns the game from unbearable to hilarious. I'd say that's pretty fair. Like, I mean, obviously, if you like the game, then, like, I'm happy for you. But from what little, you know, I have seen, it does seem like the kind of game where you really do have to just kind of take it in stride, all the ridiculous bullshit. And that's made so much easier to do when the protagonist is also a nutcase. Watching stream 160p and it still can't keep up. Oh no. I'm sorry to hear that, Zen. I'm sorry you're having such a tough time. What? Excuse me? That was completely above my head. I hate this. Yum, 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 yum. Alright, anyways. So I'm gonna go up here and they're gonna throw a truck at me, I guess. Maybe we want some hot dogs to get all the beef out in Frank. Awesome. Going back down this way. Trying to watch my Alan wait. Just DP the truck. Honestly, now that you say that, I probably should have done that. The problem is doing DP from down back is really awkward for me. So I figure it's easier to just move, try to anti-air with a normal. Please don't throw shit at me. I don't like it when you do that. They tried to hide the goo under the barrel. That's fucked up. It's littered with goo. Absolutely littered with goo. Get the shit out of my face. I'm Alan Wake, goddammit. Don't you know I'm a professional writer? You can't talk to me like that. You can't goo me like that. Anti-air the missiles that are dropped on me every day. Well, that would explain why you're still doing so well, man. Just DP those shit back to sender. There we go. Give me, yum, yum. The darkness, where's her face? That's unfortunate. I feel like people or things shouldn't wear other things' faces. The darkness controls the Taken. Yep, that makes sense. Just a little bit of something. I will switch to the pump action shotgun because I will have significantly more ammo for it. Yay! Alright, how much life do I lose? Oh, good job, Alan. Good job, big guy. Alright. What are you? Let's examine.
I needed to get the generator running.
Oh, I need to get the generator running. Oh, of course, Alan, of course. I need to get the generator running. The generator that is so conveniently slash inconveniently all the way over here. Oh, look, ammunition. I wonder if I'm gonna get attacked. How great is this? At least this one's pretty easy. Okay, baller. Oh wow, look at how many of them showed up. That's crazy. Wow, really? That didn't even get him? Okay, that time I just missed. That one was actually my fault. Don't you love it when games refuse to auto-reload for literally no reason? This right here is exactly why Alan Wake 2 is better. There's exactly the same sequence in 2 when you start the generator and no enemy shows up. Hey, that sounds like a dream come true. Does everything get super blurry and nausea inducing? But did you get to skip stones after? True. It's an important question. Guess what, pussy? Thanks. Alright, up I go. I wish this game let me skip rocks. That would make me very happy, honestly. I think that'd be pretty radical. If I could shine my flashlight on some little, you know, on some goo on the ground and then turn around, skip some rocks. It just caused that. I mean, I guess that I don't really know how it skip. I don't know how it skip rocks at the lawn in front of my place, but yeah, no, this, I'm sorry about the volume, but this shit is just like randomly cranking sometimes. Okay. Bro, I'm gonna freak the fuck out. There's no indicator for what's hitting me, and I hate it. Yeah, no, when games that just like the volume randomly changes, that shit pisses me off quite a lot. So, okay, so I'm actually just sitting here trying to get these to move. Why? Literally, where did you come from? Are you fucking kidding me? Look at this. Look at this bullshit. Oh my god, I hate it. Hitting games, let's have shit audio balance. Oh yeah, no. Like, that, it's a thing with games and with TV and with movies and everything. Like, not only are they all completely independent from one another, so there's literally no way to know what kind of volume you're going to be getting, but then in each individual product, you just have instances of complete randomness when it comes to the audio volumes of things that are happening. Like, I have the audio for me is not very high, so I miss dialogue like half the time, and then shit explodes and it blows my ears. Watching the show, and the ads started maximum loudness. Oh yeah, that sounds spectacular. Ow. So at this point, I don't even care. I'm just gonna use them. Blindly throwing the shit. Alright, and I'm out.
Do as you're told.
You do as you're told, bitch. Give me my weak ass wife back. Just so much shit in the air, you should grab Alan Rake. True. Except that I ain't no bitch. I'm an American. I pay someone else to do it. Haha, just kidding. I live in an apartment though. I pay to have a place to live.
Never loved you.
I'd believe that. We don't seem to get along very well. Destroy the tornado. Okay, game. Whatever you say. Alright, I'm sorry about volume already. I know this is about to be some bullshit. Watch out, everybody. Like, throw a flashbang in there. Come on, Alan, you got it. Don't be a bitch. Just walk into the tornado. We'll be fine. Thanks, game. I love that I literally don't have time to do anything about that. Wait here for a second. Let that charge back up. I feel like I have to yell, and I don't want to. Although, maybe this is just, maybe this is just more atmospheric. Ugh. just supposed to just spam these in the air. This is so fun and interactive. Okay, makes one of Alan break. Flare gun ammo, shall we? Got on. Firing bullshit. Like, what am I supposed to be doing here? This inch nails track. Can't I walk forward? Probably, but I don't want this game to take all this ammo away from me as soon as I do.
You'll fail,
bitch. I guess, yeah, I was supposed to just walk up into it and do it once instead of get rid of all the shit flying around in it. Like, that was just straight up misleading. You're making this up, fuck you. I think I just shot bird guys. I defeated the tornado, guys. You're just terrible at gaming? Also true, but the fact that they had infinitely refundable ammo, or re-gettable ammo, far enough away that you wouldn't be able to get back to it when you're actually in range to do things, like, that doesn't make any sense to me. To me, that says, keep firing flares from here and re-upping your ammo while you do it. Yeah, I mean, I did just kill a tornado, so I'll take it. Oh. Alan, oh god, don't belly flop. Jesus. Just made you... Can anybody hear me? Is anybody out there? Okay, I think we just reconnected. We back? Alright. No, that was not you, Zen. I could see it breaking. It just didn't tell me that it came back together. Or, like, it was saying that it was still broken for, like, that entire time, so I wasn't sure if we actually were or not. Oh, no. Zen's not back. I guess we're back. Zen's not back, which is unfortunate. But also, like, fuck this game for...
Alan, you're scaring me now.
Ruining my TV.
Come back to bed. Have you taken
Fatal pills? Belly flop? Oh, yeah.
Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman?
Oh, it did split into two, didn't it?
Fuck. I read your manuscript.
Yeah, I figured that's probably what happened, and that's really frustrating, but...
You're a genius. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, well.
Come back to bed. We'll talk more about it in the morning.
A quick Alan spank. That's me, baby. Live on stream. Bitch, let me get my clicker. Fuck you. Where's the goddamn clicker? Give me my goddamn clicker. I needs it. The hot Alan snake. Yeah.
Come back to bed, Alan.
Come back to bed, Tom.
Better. I have an absolutely enormous piece of meat. There it is. Oh, could I have killed my wife? Tough. What's up, submarine man?
You must find your way to the cabin. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass.
True. Back to bed, you Alan
Skank. It has no heart. It's filled with darkness.
Nah, I was looking at us for real.
It must fill its heart with light.
Oh. What is it? Where's the line? Cursive. Give me the line. Gotta fill his dark heart with hope with light. Whatever the fuck it is.
Don't mind him. He's Mr. Scratch.
Mr. Scratch? Criminal Minds? Oh, wait. There's an Alan fake? What the fuck is happening?
Use the clicker.
You use the clicker. Stupid submarine head having ass. Am I destroying words now? Let's go. Hey, yeah, what the fuck? Where's the shopping cart? What is happening? Playing word scramble? Oh, yeah. This one's gonna take a minute, apparently. And I'm back to having a stupid bitch flashlight, goddamn. Oh, a thermos! I want the yummy, yummy thermos. Mmm, yum, yum, yum. Bird. I don't want bird. Bird maybe tried to kill me. I don't want bird. I want phone.
I followed the idea of a path.
Wish my friends enjoyed Twin Peaks. Hey, I've never said I don't enjoy Twin Peaks. I just said I've never seen it. I don't really care about the telephone pole, shopping cart, shoebox, barrel, phone.
I'm leaving you, Alan. I met someone. I'm in love with someone else.
Oh, finally.
No, what are you saying? You can't.
Ow,
you
God damn it.
Love me.
I approve myself.
You don't even love yourself. All you do is torture yourself with work. You can't do anything.
True.
No, I love you more than anything in the world. You're my muse. Who are you? What have you done with my Alice?
Alice is straight up out here getting kidnapped.
What are you doing?
Getting Stockholm syndromes. And calling me about it and being like, Alan, I need to get a divorce. I would punch children. Yes, also true. I believe he would say that.
I promised.
Who are Zane and Barbara?
Please, untie
phone.
Me, naughty boy. I will help you write your masterpiece. I will love you forever.
What is happening?
No, you're not Barbara Jagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never written you back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
What the fuck is going on?
Put it down.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening.
Take it back to the dense paper.
Yeah, I don't want to waste any like battery on this flashlight. I'm just leaving it.
Filled with darkness.
Dark world filled with light. Where's Zero when we need him?
Where am I? Let me go.
Or was that Dante? I never remember if that was.
Your husband refused to do as he was told. All he had to do was.
I'm a naughty boy. That one was Dante.
Now you will never get her back.
Oh, tough. Well, guess what? I killed a tornado, motherfucker. I think I can do anything.
I am much older than you.
That just means you're frail.
Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
Did he just stick his hand in? Piss the old lady, oh yeah. Let's get elbow deep up in that old lady. Yeah, that's the post-orgasm glow flow. He gave her a literal godly orgasm and she erupted in light.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure.
Good for you, Alan.
There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement.
Yep,
but the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where it's
this what sex
wrong.
Is. Did I just have sex? Oh my god.
There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
It's like JoJo fisting his mom from behind in part 4. True.
Alice?
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 Jason? Jason?
Oh no!
Oh no! Wait, what was that? Oh no! Oh no! Alice! Turned her into a donut. Turned her into a donut and then back into not a donut. Oh no! Like, that was just like, that was some bad delivery there. Oh no! I love it. Oh boy. Love how Weird Al Allen jumps are. Oh yeah. No, he actually jumps like a toddler. He very legitimately jumps like a toddler. Yeah, he's a writer. He's not designed to... Actually, I say that. My girlfriend's also a writer, so I shouldn't be too loud. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Guys, oh my god, she's alive. Holy shit.
He saved her. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Alan?
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 They gave her clothes? Well, I mean, I'm happy they gave her clothes, because otherwise I'd get in trouble. Maybe the game did a Doki Doki and read that I was streaming. It's also why Alan Wake 2 is better. Well, I mean, I don't know. You know, I'm straight, so nakedness for the sake of nakedness is not equally interesting to me between men and women. But hey, I mean, if you're happy with gross, overweight, old man pee-pee, then I'm happy for you, Zen. I'm happy Alan Wake 2 can fill that void for you. Definitely, that's what it is. It's from a place of hatred, not from a place of, you know, preference. Oh yay, old man, who I'm probably supposed to remember. Oh yeah, let's fucking go, old man. I like those two. I like how they're supposed to actually be Odin and Thor. Don't be so selfish, everyone suck peepees. I mean, everyone could. Oh, okay. Did I just beat the game? Okay. What's up, Pingo? Good timing. Huh. Okay. Oh, is it one of these, really? Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, that was something. So I have to play the DLC. Does this game have DLC? Hold on. It was all a dream. Let's see, DLC. Bonus materials. And collector's edition extras, which I have. Listen to Remedy Team's comments about the locations and design. Okay, so that's like commentary shit. Okay, and then that none of this actually has to do with the game. Okay. On lead. Flo's allergic to narrative. Okay, so post-game review. Okay. I'm down to do a post-game review. And you guys, we'll just have that be the screen that you guys look at. Yes, thank you, Alan Wake. Okay. So, post-game review for Alan Wake is... There you go. Let's see, add to finished. Remove from big games to try. Remove from to play on stream, because I did. A. No, post-game review is that I definitely would have liked it if it was designed well. But the minute-to-minute gameplay is really, really atrocious, and it kept distracting me from the story, so even if I was invested, I wouldn't have been able to figure out what was going on. And part of that's because I'm a dumbass, but part of it is because I was literally too busy hating playing it to pay attention to everything going on. I 100% understand why people would like this game. And for those people, I am happy for them. I'm happy that they enjoyed the game the way it was made. But for me, I could not look past the bad parts because they were so frequent and apparent. So it really tainted what would have otherwise been a pretty fun and interesting experience. So what you're saying is that you would like the game if it was good? Yes, pretty much. It's possible to make a good narrative-based game with shitty gameplay. I mean, yeah, like, so I guess it depends on your definition of shitty. Like, my problem isn't even the concept behind the design. Like, I understand why they made the general choices that they made, and that isn't even a big deal. It was just the execution. And some of the concepts are bad, like the wave-based stuff and all that, and enemies popping up fucking behind you, like, whatever. But the flashlight and the shooting and that part of the gameplay would have been fine if it was done well. And it would have made sense, and, well, you know, as much sense as it would have. But it felt so terrible that, like, I couldn't enjoy it. And I couldn't look past it to enjoy the parts of it that I would have otherwise enjoyed. So, but that's just me. That's obviously my personal take. For those of you that have played the game and love the game, I can absolutely understand why, and you're probably just less picky than I am. Celeste is a good example. It's a game with a cool narrative, but focuses on good 2D platforming. Yeah, I think Celeste's narrative is... I haven't finished the game, but Celeste's narrative is less direct. Dark Souls, like, barely has a narrative, from my understanding. It's all, like, exploring and figuring stuff out yourself. But with something like Celeste, the story, like, there is a story, and it's actively unfolding around you, but it's only relevant when it's relevant. But with Alan Wake, the story is the motivating factor, and it's kind of a jumbled mess, but that's part of the point. But the narrative being the driving force means that the narrative is supposed to carry the story, but when the gameplay feels that bad, I can't get past it, which is just, that's just me. Does we have to go out of your way to figure it out? Yeah. Yeah, which is true. But, like, I guess my point, Flo, is that, like, I get what you're saying, but I feel like they're different by default, you know, because Alan Wake is a narrative that happens to be a game, whereas something like Celeste is a game that has a narrative, if that makes sense. Alan Wake could have just as easily been a movie or a TV show or a book, but Celeste obviously can really only be a game. Like, the story could be anything, but it is a game, whereas Alan Wake could be kind of whatever. narrative-focused games are flawed, in my opinion. If you're going to be lazy with the gameplay, then you should just make a TV series or movie. Yeah, I don't disagree. Like, part of what I love about video games, generally speaking, is that they are a way for you to, for you as a consumer, to directly interact and, depending on the game, influence how things happen. When you're talking about a game with a narrative, at least, you have influence over what that narrative is and becomes, even if you don't actually make, even if your choices don't actually impact the story, you are still directly related to what's going on. But when you have something like Alan Wake, where it's about a character and his story, and you're just along for the ride, it kind of like, obviously there are plenty of games like that that have, you know, characters that, you know, that aren't just nameless, faceless, mouthless whatevers for you know, stand-ins for the players. But Alan Wake was so much about the story with so little gameplay. I agree. There wasn't a ton of point of making it a game over something else. But I can understand why they chose to make it a game. Other people played Alan Wake 1 before said already. Honestly, don't remember the gameplay being bad. Honestly, I think it's mainly a you problem. Granted, some of the enemy waves were too much. So part of it is definitely a me problem, but it's a me problem because it was a game problem. Like, the movement and the, like, the shooting itself was fine. It's the shooting, the firing of the guns was whatever. I don't like not having a reticle, but having the flashlight kind of act as one was, made it, it was fine. Like, the hit detection was pretty generous. But the problem was that the way combat encounters were designed paired so horribly with the movement physics that it turned into something way worse than it, than the sum of its parts. Like, the movement didn't feel very good, but that would have been fine if not for the fact that 7 enemies would show up at once. I would have no way of knowing it. They would stun lock me just because Alan Wake trips and falls for 30 full seconds every time he gets hit. And then, you know, they would pop up around me in places I can't see without any way for me to know that they were there. And then, like, that, it's just a compounding list of issues that were, that felt like different people designed different parts of combat, which is weird. And I don't know why that would be the case, but that's what it felt like the whole time. If that makes any sense. Some of it was definitely just me being bad, and I will 100%, like, I will not deny that that was at least partially the case in some instances, but I do think the fundamental design and the, or whether it was design or, you know, an accident, the way it turned out, but the fundamental design of how the combat encounters worked was just bad, frustrating, and not well made. 100% just fighting waves of enemies with a shitty flashlight and pistol in the same open dark forest area every 10 minutes until you reach the next cutscene. It's beyond lazy, yeah. Also fix that in Alan Wake 2. You can backroll to avoid follow-up attacks after being hit. That's good. Yeah, like, I think it's just, because, hold on, when did this game come out? This game came out, I don't know when it was first released, but it was released on Steam in 2012. So I don't really want to say it's a product of the time, because there are plenty of games that came out in 2012 that were functional. But I'm inclined to say it was a product of the times, if for no other reason than because it, like, there are a lot of very simple fixes for obnoxious things that seem to be missing. And I feel like a big portion of that is because they didn't 100% know what they were doing. Problem is, fans of this game are going to tell you to ignore this and focus on the story, but it's kind of impossible. Most of the game is just that. Yeah. Game originally came out in 2010. Okay. But yeah, so that's what I'm saying, Flo. Like, the, I was thinking if this game came out like a lot earlier than that, then I would say it's a product of the times. But if it came out in 2010, like, there are plenty of games that came out around the time that, you know, are functional games. It really just breaks down to, I don't know what their library was like prior to Alan Wake, but it really seemed like the devs went into this with a really good idea that they didn't know how to make happen. So they just made the parts they knew how and then threw in the rest. Like, the narrative, again, I didn't really care for it. I didn't really understand what was going on most of the time, which part of it was probably because I'm stupid, but for the most part, the story and the characters were campy in a way where they probably weren't supposed to be, but they were fun enough to interact with and be a part of. But the gameplay itself just doesn't hold up at all. Fair Remedy only made Max Payne 1 and 2 before that. Okay, so that's what I was saying. Like, I wasn't sure what else they had made, so I wasn't sure how familiar they were. I also haven't played Max Payne, so I know Max Payne, but I've never played them, so I don't know if they're really any better. I know they are technically supposed to be combat-centric, but with, you know, their gimmick. Red Dead Redemption came out in 2010, yet it had a focus on narrative and fun gameplay loop. Yeah, Zen does make a good point that it's kind of comparing apples and oranges, because that's a massive studio with a massive track record and a massive amount of funding. Like, it's kind of, yeah, I understand what you're saying, Flo, and I don't disagree with the with the idea of what you're saying, but it is kind of hard to compare the two, given, like, I don't know much about Remedy as a studio. I don't know if they have anything, like, I don't know what kind of funding they have. I don't know what kind of size they have, like, what kind of staff or anything like that. But I'm assuming they're on the smaller side, especially compared to someone like Rockstar. Remedy is a small, dedicated studio. It's always aimed at making a story as much of a multimedia narrative as possible. Okay. So, yeah. So, if they are a small studio that focuses on trying to make something interesting and unique, then it's not terribly surprising that they whiff sometimes on whether it's entire games, which I wouldn't know, or just on parts of games. It's not very surprising in that case. Like, if it was a company like, I guess Rockstar is a fine example. I don't necessarily love their games, but if you're talking about a studio like Rockstar, if they came out with Alan Wake, people would call them buffoons for the way that the game controls. But if it's a small studio that was focused on trying to make something interesting more than necessarily than something high quality, I can understand how it turned out the way it did. Funny enough, Rockstar made Max Payne 3 because Remedy couldn't. Oh, that is kind of funny, actually. Max Payne with comics, Alan Wake with novels, Quantum Break with a television series that was going on with it, Control with Alan Wake being a crossover element. Oh, that's neat. Also, actually, I've heard of Quantum Break. What is Quantum Break? I know Quantum Break. Hold on. Quantum Break. Oh, this was them. Oh, interesting. I didn't realize this was the same guys, but that makes a lot of sense. That's cool. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. It's fine that you couldn't enjoy it. I'm glad you played it, but I'd rather have one Remedy than a million Konamis. Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. Like, I am not, and this is part of what I mean by a product of the times, is that not just the times in general, but also the times in, you know, in regards to the studio itself. If they had only made two games prior, I'm not surprised, like I said, I'm not surprised that they didn't 100% know what they were doing. Obviously, it would have been better if they did, but experimenting with what they were doing, trying out new things, and ending up with Alan Wake, I don't think is a bad thing. I'm just personally, selfishly, and because I have no bias, like, a little, you know, a little sad that it didn't end up being way better than it was. But, like I said, I am very happy for the people that do enjoy the game, and I can very much understand what you're saying, Hiro. I would also rather have a studio that makes things that are interesting and unique that people enjoy than a company that just snatches up IPs and ruins them. Like, I'm more than happy to have a small studio exist that makes interesting experiences, even if they're not ones that I end up liking, than have a company that just makes a shit product over and over again. Absolutely hated Quantum Break, so I do miss sometimes indeed. Also disliked Control. Yeah, and I mean, obviously, at the end of the day, a lot of it just comes down to
what it is that you enjoy.
A lot of people can look past poor minute-to-minute gameplay if the story is something that interests them enough. I can't. Then again, if they had already worked on Max Payne, they should have known how to create a decently fun gameplay loop. That's kind of what I was thinking too, but I don't, I've never played Max Payne, so I don't actually know. What's next? Please don't say Spider-Man 2. So I don't have Spider-Man 2 because I don't have a PlayStation. So I will get it eventually when it comes on PC, but that's not going to be happening anytime soon. This is actually a good opportunity for us to look at all my Steam games. Hey, hold on. Let me go turn on a light, but we can just look through these, and you guys can help me decide what to play next because I'm actually not against that. I think that's a good way to spend the time. Because at this point, I'm probably not going to start a new game tonight. But we can definitely decide and get something set up, like, to start next week. Not here to shit on anyone's parade, by the way, just expressing my thoughts on these kinds of games. Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. Having the discussions that we have about these things are designed with, or, you know, the idea of them is to talk about things that we all are interested in. As long as you're not actively attacking anyone for their opinion, then have whatever opinion you want, you know? Play Hotline Miami? Okay, hold on. Where is it? Is it in here? No, it was somewhere else. Technical issues. Nope, something else. Okay, whatever. I've played a decent number of hours of the first Hotline Miami, and I despise the controls. The controls make me want to blow my brains out. Danganronpa gets a plus one. Danganronpa 1, where is it? The first Danganronpa, finish it eventually. The first Danganronpa, which should be in here, except that it's not. We could also, this is also another category to look through. But yes, no, I played the first Danganronpa. Oh, Trigger Happy Havoc's right here. I played 12 hours of this game. I loved every second of it. And then the game crashed and I lost like 3 hours of progress and I uninstalled it. I got so mad at losing that much progress that I did straight up just uninstall the game and haven't touched it since. And thankfully, it's been long enough now that I remember very little, so I would actually be super down to play Danganronpa. But yeah, so we'll look through, because this one is games that I have that I haven't tried that I want to. This one is like part of a series, I guess. Zero Time Dilemma is part of a series, so don't want to do that. But yeah, so these are games that I either haven't played or haven't played in long enough that I don't remember anything about them. I'll Finish It Eventually is games that I've played recently enough and dropped for one reason or another. Cyberpunk with nudity. Cyberpunk was an option. Now that the game is supposedly good, I do want to play Cyberpunk. But that might be, depending on if you guys would want me to, that would either be something I could play on stream or something that I would just play on my own time once I finish what I'm currently playing. So we've got, what, two or three votes on Danganronpa, which I would be super down for. But we can keep looking. Got a bunch of Deus Ex games. Doom Eternal, I beat the first Doom. Remove from here because I'm already playing it. Let's see. Hatful Boyfriend is a good one. Romance Judy, because she's the only correct choice. I believe you. When I eventually play the game, I'll try to remember that. Jazz Punk, which is a weird little fucking thing. Lisa, I feel like, might be a good one for stream, but I don't totally know. Tails is, yes, that's true. Tails is still up, is still still an option. Because I beat Season 1 of The Walking Dead, but I'd be down to replay it and then do Season 2. We also have Tales from the Borderlands. We have Wolf Among Us. I have fucking Temtem. Jazz Punk, Grim Fandango, Among Us. No, if you want Among Us, I think I have it in here somewhere, don't I? No, okay, then I just have it in Playing With People. I do have Transistor. I started playing Bastion, and I got through a good chunk of it, and I just got super bored, so I stopped. Replay Doki Doki and Romance Natsuki like a real man. I could replay Doki Doki and go a different path. That is an option. Let's get some. Hold on, I'm gonna pull that up real quick. Sticky notes. Okay, no, I want this. Okay. So, Danganronpa, Tales from the Borderlands, Doki Doki X Natsuki, what else? Jazz Punk. So, Grim Fandango, I'm not sure if I actually have the entire game. I don't know if this is the full game or if this is, like, just chapter one. Because I don't remember how it worked. I think it's the whole thing. But I feel like when I got it, there was something about it only being chapter one. So, I don't know exactly what to do with that. But I'll put it down. Grim Fandango's a 90s game? Yeah, no, I know. That much I know. Don't you worry. I know it's a, you know, sort of point and click kind of game. I'll put Cyber Bitch. So yeah, obviously I have to scroll through, but these are the games that I have not really touched or haven't touched in long enough. But there's also these three, which they don't have any narratives to them, so it's not like they would be, I would play them a lot necessarily. I'll Finish It Eventually. These are all games that I've started and dropped for one reason or another, so for the most part, I would be willing to give these another go. Some of them would be significantly more interesting than others. Like Dragon Quest, I actually finished, and then the game was like, just kidding, no you didn't. There's a full, you're halfway through the game, even though the narrative was done. So this one is shelved for now, but I am actually planning on finishing it. Also, that's a lie. I haven't played this in the past 2 weeks. Whatever. But yeah, so that's... I'm not going to restart this. So that's off the table. But pretty much anything else in this list, I would also be down to give another try. So if anybody sees anything here that they want to add to the list... I know, Cursive, you said Shovel Knight. I don't know if you meant it. But I would be down to play Shovel Knight, because it is fun. And I think this is the third system I own Shovel Knight on, and I still haven't beat the game. Just because I'm a dummy. But I'll put it on the list. Shovel Knight. I should beat Shovel Knight, but I'm not sure if that's something you guys would be interested in actually seeing. It's not like... It's not incredibly interactive. Obviously, neither is Alan Wake, but at least you guys, you know, have feelings about it that we can talk about. So Shovel Knight might just be something that I play on my own time at some point. But yeah, is there anything else here or in the big one? We can also, depending, some of my finished games I would be willing to replay. Some of them I played too recently, wouldn't want to, but some of them I would absolutely be willing to. So is there anything in here that piques anybody's interest? Titanfall 2 story mode. Dude, the Titanfall 2 campaign is so goddamn good. Titanfall 2 campaign... I think the baby that lives below me is currently crying. But yeah, like Metal Gear 5, Orwell was pretty neat. Inside's a great game. Donut County was small and fun. World Tour, that's true, actually. I like World Tour. I said it, I think, before, either Wednesday or Monday. But I'm in a really awkward spot with World Tour where I don't want to... I don't want to learn modern and do, you know, plug in a controller to play it, but I really do want to get it done because it's there and it would be a good, like, it'd be a fun one to interact. So it's up there on the options. It's more just I'm being a baby about it. Well, Tor will keep getting bigger with more characters in new areas. That's true. What the fuck is happening? I'm assuming you guys can't hear that. But I'm just hearing some very strange noises coming from my neighbors. Yeah, no, Flo, the problem is that I can't really play it on my hitbox because the movement would be so fucking awkward. But, so I would want to play it on a pad, of which I have multiple options. But I don't want to learn how to play, I can't learn how to play Street Fighter on a pad. So I would have to play modern, which isn't that big a deal, but... Play with keyboard? I actually probably could. I mean, I know another option is to use, like, keyboard for movement and then my my hitbox for the actual gameplay, I think, right? Like, I can swap back and forth like that. Personally, I think it's best just to World Tour with gamepad. That's fair. Too tough, swap back and forth, yeah. Hold HP and adjust. Yeah. I mean, I guess it wouldn't be the worst thing to just do it, because it's not like I'm really playing Street Fighter. I'm just kind of playing the fun mode. Did it all on Leverless? Okay. Move the pad, switch the stick for fights. That's what I was thinking. Something like that. Like moving with something else, but that also seems like kind of a hassle. But not that big a deal. So, okay, so I think this is probably a pretty decent chunk of options here. So, Would you guys rather, because this is really small, I don't know if you can even read this comfortably. Camera controls take a bit to adjust to, mess around the battle hub, get adjusted to the camera. Yeah, that makes sense. Because I remember when I did the battle hub, it was a fucking, yeah, I didn't like it. But we'll see. Just avoid NA1. Yeah, I know NA1 is a crazy mess. I've seen posts on various places that are just like, NA1 is actually a complete fucking dumpster fire. Which is funny, and I kind of want to go see it, but probably not on stream. Some wild edgelords in there, yeah. I'd believe that. Yeah, no, definitely not on stream. So, okay, so you guys can't see this very well because this is very small. But would you rather... Nice library? Thank you, Pingo. I appreciate that. I have everything categorized in a bunch of different categories. So this also isn't everything. These are big games to try that I'm willing to try that look interesting. So I kind of need to re-go through all of these and see if any of that's changed. But yes, so okay, do you guys want to just make a decision now, or do you want me to have you guys vote on it? On what we play. Because I'm always happy to have you guys vote, and it might make it easier, but if you guys would rather not bother and just come to a decision now, we can try to do that. Yeah, NA1 is just filled with degenerates. Something about NA1 specifically. Play Super Seducer? Hold on, how much is it? Oh, it's $4? Wait, that's actually fucking hype. That's not my birthday, by the way. That's just autofills. I could actually play Super Seducer. They're DLC? What? $69 off, nice. Let your girlfriend decide. Oh, that, you know what? Actually, that's a good, hold on. Let me go see what she's doing. I'll be right back. Okay, she's on her way. Okay.
I'm here to save the day.
She's here to save the day. Okay, so we have a list of options here that we wrote down from stuff I already own. Flo suggested Super Seducer, which is funny, and it's only $4, so I could just buy it. But Hero makes a good point. He would only agree if we pirate it, which I don't think I want to do. So that kind of takes off the table.
What, you don't want to give financial support to the creators of Super Seducer?
No, I'm not sure that I do. How much is closing shift? Yeah, type for me, thank you. Chill is art, the closing shift? This one? Is this the one you were talking about, Zen? 69% off, it's not $4.20. Beyond disappointed. Well, this is $6 that I'm not sure I want to spend. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that is. All right, anyways.
Hold on, was I supposed to be the one making a sandwich?
I don't know. Okay, so these are the options that we have right now that we came up with.
Is Cyberbitch intended to be Cyberpunk?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So Danganronpa, which I've played before, which is a lot of fun.
I think that would be a good one for the stream, though. I think it fits your vibe.
That's what I was thinking, too. They also, a lot of them tended to agree. We have Tales from the Borderlands, which is very narrative. Do you know the Tales games? told you about them? Were you seen them?
No, but really. I'll just blindly trust you on that.
Okay. Tales from the Borderlands would work. I could replay Doki Doki Literature Club and just go a different path. I could play Jazz Punk, which is just ridiculous mess. Grim Fandango, which is kind of a point and click. I'll show you what it kind of looks like. Like, you know, it's pretty old. But yeah, you just go around and do things.
It's cute.
Yeah, it is cute. And then Cyberpunk, Shovel Knight, which I think you know, right?
Yeah, I know what Shovel Knight is.
Yeah, you know
Knight
Shovel Knight.
Yeah.
I thought so. Titanfall 2 campaign. It's first-person shooter. It's pretty short. I've played it before, but it's a lot of fun. And then World Tour, which is the story mode in Street Fighter.
Okay. I will say I think it's too soon for you to do Doki Doki again.
Okay. That makes sense.
I am leaning towards Danganronpa.
Danganronpa?
That's the one.
Danganronpa?
Also, Zen, I wasn't really worried about it. I was just going to correct and say that I've been playing Baldur's Gate all day.
It is true. She has actually been no life in Baldur's Gate today.
Mm-hmm.
This is our third time talking today, something like that?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. So thank you guys for getting her out of the room for a few minutes. So, okay. So she votes Danganronpa. Grim Fandango will be good, but it's all... Also, it's an adventure game, so there's some jank. Okay, I gotcha. Not quite Alan Jank. So how many votes for Danganronpa? Because I would 100% be down to play this game again. As you can potentially see, I got 12 hours in. Okay, Hero's down for it. Flo's down for it. We can pull the trigger on that. All right. Ha.
I'm laughing like I'm in on the joke.
It's just a trigger happy happy.
Well, yes, I saw that there was like that nice.
Yeah, the reticle like the.
Yeah. Uh huh.
Mm-hmm. That was it. That was the whole joke.
Oh, that was the whole.
It was
thing?
Just a pun.
Well, I knew it was a pun.
Yeah. Well, no, but I'm saying it was just a pun.
I know it was just a pun. I just wasn't sure if it had more meaning actually in the game as opposed to just based on that nice little image there.
Okay,
I'm
I gotcha.
Not. Stupid.
I know you're not stupid. I just didn't know, like, I didn't think you, I didn't know what you meant, because I was like, it's just a pun about the name. Like, that's all it is.
No, I got
but,
it.
But yeah, I wasn't sure what you meant by more than that, because I thought that was pretty straightforward. Okay, sounds good to Pingo. Do a Valley Girl voice in it? Yes. If there is not voice acting, which I now don't remember.
Flo's on my side.
Flo is on your side.
Thanks, Flo.
I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean it. It's okay. She'll beat me later.
Yeah, I'm very physically aggressive,
mm-hmm.
apparently.
It's true.
It's news to me, but I'll take it.
Yeah, no, it's fine. But yes, if there is voice acting, then I don't know how much I'd be able to get away with doing stupid voices. But if there is not voice acting, then I can get away with doing stupid voices. I just don't remember. Nice save. Thank you. I appreciate that. Okay. That sounds good. So we'll do Danganronpa.
Getting started early on the voices, I see.
Danganronpa to play on stream. There we go. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot to add stuff in there already. All right, whatever.
Smooth.
Like moments of voice acting. Okay, so like little bits here and there. So, okay, if the whole thing isn't voice acted, then yeah, I can definitely do some voice acting when there isn't any. I can totally do that. Danganronpa. All right. Thank you for your assistance.
You're so welcome. I will see all of you lovely people someday when I emerge once again from Baldur's Gate.
Once you finish the game a couple of times. And,
that's it. I'm only like 115 hours in.
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah.
No big deal.
It's fine.
All right. So decision has been made. I will get that set up for next week. We will play Danganronpa, Twigga Happy Havoc. I'm really excited to play this again. It has been a long time. I played this 6 years ago. More than 6 years ago now at this point. So that's very exciting. I remember bits and pieces, but no, like, real details. Great work swapping between the voice mods. Thank you. I've been practicing, because I knew something like this was going to happen at some point. Have to do a lot of voice acting, prepare your throat. Oh boy, I actually didn't really think about that. All right, I'll try to get a night. What I need to do is clean my my giant reusable water bottle. A lot of reading, yay! We love reading. No, but I do remember this being a lot of fun. So I will look forward to this very much. But okay, so with that decision made, and with Alan Wake complete, I love weeding. Is it a fly? All right, he got away. But yes, with this decision made and with Alan Wake complete, I think this is where I'm going to call it for the night. Obviously, we're keeping it pretty short today, but that's all right. We finished our main objective and then got a secondary objective done, so I'm not upset. Thank you guys very much for hanging out with me today. Sorry to be such a Debbie Downer about Alan Wake, but I really didn't like the game very much. But I appreciate you all hanging out with me, sharing your input. Congrats on finishing the Wake and Bake. Thanks. I appreciate that. Who should I send you guys to? I'm going to be selfish. I'm going to send you guys over to Sean for the big fat 400 person shout out. Handy capable Sean. All right. Fuck, this guy didn't like the game I liked exactly. But yes, thank you guys very much for hanging out with me today. I appreciate you all very much. I will be back on Monday, you know, back on the Street Fighter, back on the grind as per usual. Hopefully not. I don't think there should be anything that will get in the way of me being able to join a Hero stream on Sunday. So I will look forward to seeing everybody there for those of you who are able to make it. And until next time, I love you all and peace out, everybody.
Aw, looks strange. Don't say something like that. It's embarrassing. Aww.
There's no such thing as too fast.
Dimwet. Dimwet. Winding up a... Winding up a car. Going all in base. I was trying to bait it. I thought you played with my cock before? If I have, I don't remember. Tim West. Let's go. Ooh, woo. Tamwax. Ooh, woo.
If I can't lick the Colonel's fingers, I'm deleting my Twitch account. That's the plan. If at some point somebody's fingers, ideally the Colonel's, but somebody's fingers are not licked, this stream is over.
Forever.
Figured it out.
The truth is, I don't like playing games. I only like winning. So I cheat as often as I can, in as many ways as I can, guarantee that I win. So fucking pleased with myself.